It's important to have a plan when it comes to wiring. When it comes to properly wiring your vehicle, you need to avoid adopting the yes, this should be good enough mentality or philosophy. Starting from the ground up, you do not want to rely on the chassis or the cage for your ground path. While the chassis should be properly grounded to the battery, you do not want to rely on a chassis for your primary ground. You'll always want to make sure you're on a heavy gauge ground wire directly from the battery to the engine. A 1/0 or larger cable is ideal, and I recommend running this directly to a cylinder head. If you have an engine with multiple cylinder heads, run at least a 4-gauge cable between the heads. Every wiring job starts with selecting the correct wire for the task at hand. Always make sure your wire is temperature rated as well as solvent rated for automotive use. You will commonly see automotive wire associated with some letter codes such as TXL, SXL, GXL, and SGX. Holley's main engine harnesses utilize TXL wire. The primary difference between them is going to be the thickness of the insulation. They all have a cross-linked polyethylene insulation that is both heat as well as abrasion resistant. The primary difference being in the thickness for weight as well as bulk savings. And when you deal with TXL, it's the thinnest, and SGX is going to be the thickest. SGX cable insulation is generally used on battery cables to help keep those sparks from flying in areas that you don't want them to be. When you're running certain sensors, like say a mag pickup, wheel speed, or drive shaft speed sensor, wire that's susceptible to noise, you should also make sure that you're using a shielded wire, which will help block out some of that interference that could cause you some issues down the road. Holley offers a nice selection of plug-and-play engine-specific harnesses for GM, Ford, and popular Chrysler applications, with more always being added. We currently have them available for GM tune port injection and LS applications, as well as Ford modular, Ford Coyote, and late model Hemi platforms. Holley also offers plug-and-play solutions for many popular electronic transmissions, as well as drive-by-wire throttle body applications. If you're going into something that's not quite plug-and-play, Holley offers a good selection of universal harnesses for throttle body injected applications, as well as multi-port combinations. Holley also offers some 15-foot-long non-terminated harnesses, as you see here. While not recommended for the novice, the unterminated harness lends itself well to custom applications. If wiring's not your strong suit, you're really going to be better off starting with a pre-terminated harness and making small modifications as required. Be sure that the wire gauge will support the component's minimum voltage requirements. For example, you've just upgraded your fuel pump to support that new two-stage nitrous system that you're going to install, and your existing plan might have been to use the factory 16-gauge fuel pump circuit. However, your old fuel pump pulled 10 amps, and the new fuel pump could pull potentially up to 20. Your fuel pump manufacturer recommends a minimum of 12 volts to operate effectively. You need to take a step back and ask yourself a simple question. Will this work? Before you say, yep, this should be good enough, you want to take a look at your wiring, and we've provided this handy chart as a general reference that provides a few general recommendations on wire gauges as they relate to load as well as circuit length. You want to make sure that when you use this, use as a basic guideline, as the bands may be a little bit different and this should be the minimum that you would use. You can get a little bit more specific and break out a calculator to determine your voltage drop with some simple math. We know that voltage is equal to the sum of your amperage load or your current multiplied by total resistance. So you can calculate your voltage drop with some simple math. You can grab out your calculator, and we know that voltage equals resistance times current. So on an average 16-gauge automotive wire, it's going to have a resistance value somewhere in the neighborhood of 4 milliohms per foot, or 0.004 ohms. If you take our total of 30 feet of wire that was required to complete our circuit from our battery positive to our device and its return path back to the battery ground, we'll have a total resistance of 0.004 times 30, which equals 0.12 ohms. Multiplied times our 20-amp load of our new fuel pump, we'll see that we have a voltage drop of 2.4 volts. If your average vehicle voltage runs at about 13 and we subtract 2.4, your pump will be trying to run at 10.6 volts, and we know that that's just not going to be sufficient. At a minimum, the end could be poor performance up to and including pump failure. Because resistance results in heat, and heat results in increased resistance, a possible electrical fire could be the end result. For most applications, I wire fuel pumps with a 10 or a 12-gauge wire, and sometimes larger. 10-gauge wire has a resistance value of about 0.001 ohms. Multiplied times our 30-foot in length, we end up with a total of 0.03 ohms times 20 feet, which ends up giving us a voltage drop of 0.6 volts. With our 13-volt average, this ends up with a voltage drop resulting at 12.4 volts at the pump, and this falls well within our manufacturer's requirements for proper pump operation. Always keep in mind that this does not take into account resistance that you could have through fuses, as well as relays and your connectors and your wiring. It's always recommended to check the resistance of the circuit from end to end by simply taking your digital volt ohmmeter and checking your resistance from one end of the circuit and complete it to the other, and make sure that it lines up where you need to be. If the numbers don't add up, you need to figure out what's causing that excessive resistance and make corrections before proceeding. Always follow manufacturer's recommendations. It may not always seem like it, but in the long run, it's really going to be cheaper and safer doing it right the first time. You can never go too big when it comes to selecting primary wire for your fuel injectors, your ignition, as well as your fuel pump. If in doubt, go larger on your wiring gauges. For more recommendations and tips on properly wiring your vehicle, check out other great Holley Tech videos.